Hello, good morning, and thank you, Vincent and Xavier, for having accepted this proposal. Today, I'm going to present you results obtained after the lithic procurement at the lithic characterization, the raw material characterization of lithic tools recovered at Montlleó, and how this study has allowed us to trace past human roots. Well, the work that I present you here had two main goals. The first one was to characterize lithic raw materials recovered at Montlleó open air site. This characterization was done at several scales of analysis. We first did some textural and micropalaeontological analysis at the stereoscopic microscope, then petrographic studies, and we finally included geochemical analysis by energy dispersive X-ray fluorescence and laser-ablation inductively coupled plasma mass spectrometry. And the second goal of this work was to trace human mobility and territoriality from these hunter-gatherer groups across the Pyrenees by trying to relate the data obtained after the characterization of the archaeological materials with the potentially used geological formations. And doing this, we use statistical procedures to relate the geochemical data. The site of Montlleó is an open-air site which is located in northeast Iberia. It is placed in the near to the Segre River basin, which is the most suitable natural road to cross the Pyrenees by the eastern part, and the only one that was surely open during the last glacial maximum besides of the coastline. The site is just placed in this hill in the Cerdanya Valley, which is a high altitude valley at more than 1,000 meters above the sea level, and the site is just placed just here at 1,144 meters. It was discovered in 1998 because you have here two images. The first one is from 1956 and this one from the 80s. The site is just here in this hill. And you can observe that, in fact, during the 60s and 70s, there were some mining works near the site, and due to these mining works, several fractures in the hill where the site is located, the hill was eroded, and thanks to this, the site was discovered, because in this fracture, some archaeological materials appeared. So the site has been annually excavated since the 2000 and is still under excavation. There have been three main areas. The most important one, this sector B of about 30 meters squares that have been excavated. And at least until now, we have differentiated two different human occupations, to different archaeological levels. The first one, where we first excavated an archaeological level that has been dated in the Lower Magdalenian between 20,500 Cal BP. And then we found that there was an ancient occupation of the site, almost dated from the Solutrean Badegoulian and dated by radiocarbon at almost 22,500 Cal BP. So we studied the lithic raw materials recovered at both archaeological levels, and what we observed it was that there is a polylithological complex with several rock types that were mostly used. In fact, we found that there were a lot of rhyolites, quartz, quartzite, lydite, rock crystals, where the origin is most locally and regionally. But in fact, the chert was the main lithology exploited, with several identified types. And the most interesting thing is that despite rhyolites, quartz, quartzite, and lydites are from local origin, are outcropping in the Cerdanya Valley, chert doesn't outcrop in this valley, so it comes from outside the Cerdanya Valley. So determining the origin, it was very interesting. By microscopic and petrographic analysis, we already distinguished until seven types of chert. There were the most important ones, types 1 and 2, that were represented in both levels and in a high percentage. And then we observed types 3 and 4, two types of marine chert that appeared not so much represented, but they appear recurrently in all the archaeological levels. And then we also observed three other types of chert, 5, 6, and 7, sorry for the photograph, it doesn't appear, that were represented by scarce elements. There were chert that were arrived to the site in a specific moment of the occupation. So, And already with macroscopic and petrographic studies, it was already possible to connect these archaeological, some of these archaeological charts with a specific geological formation. It was the case for types 3 and 4, which I said they appeared not in a high amount, but regularly in all the sequence. For type 3, the origin, here is the site, and the origin for type 3 has to be in fact, here, the outcrops, and for type 4, the origin is just here in the southern Pyrenees. So at least we know that there are charts coming from the north and also coming from the south of the Pyrenees. The problem was with types 1 and 2, the most represented chert types, because at both slopes of the Pyrenees, both at the north and the south, we had geological formations with the same characteristics at the macroscopic and microscopic scale. So we were not able just to relate these archaeological charts with one specific geological formation. So for this, we applied geochemical analytical techniques. First, we did energy dispersive X-ray fluorescence with the aim to quantify major and minor elements represented in these charts. And then we applied LAEC-PMS with the aim to quantify the trace elements represented in charts. You can see here more than 200 geological samples were studied and almost 200 archaeological samples were studied. I have to say that both techniques are non-destructive or almost non-destructive for LAEC-PMS. So our aim was to analyze the highest amount of samples possible just to have a great idea of the representativity of the charts that were analyzed. So I present here results obtained after the analysis of the type 1, which is a lacustrine chert type and is the most represented chert type in the site of Montlleó. And first, we applied EDXRF to quantify major and minor elements. We quantified 9 oxides, and already with the EDXRF, we had some ideas. In fact, you have here the site, and we had 6 geological formations that could have been used by these groups. 2 were located, I will be the editor, but I can't with the microphone. So 2 were located in the northern Pyrenees, 2 Miocene formations. And then we had 4 geological formations located in the southern Pyrenees, 1 from the Maastrichtian in orange, 1 from the Oligocene in blue, another 1 from the Oligocene just here in brown, and finally the Miocene chert from the Ebro Basin. So what we observe with the EDXRF here is presented a PCA with the median value of the archaeological samples and each geological outcrop studied. You cannot see, but here is the median of the archaeological samples, and what we can observe is that there are some outcrops that seems to be closer than others that are far away, just here or here. So what we then did was to search for the most represented elements. In fact, were silica, calcium, and aluminium. We did this scattered plot with all the samples that were analyzed. The black points are the archaeological samples, and the squares are the geological samples, one for each outcrop. So what we observe is that there were some formations that were far away, others closer. Here we observe these formations that could be discarded by EDXRF. In fact, we have the archaeological samples here, and these formations are far away from the main archaeological dispersion, so they could already be discarded by EDXRF. They are the Oligocene charts from the southern Pyrenees, and also one of the formations from the northern Pyrenees, these Miocene charts. Then we observed that there were 2 other formations that there did not fit very well with the main archaeological dispersion, but they were not too far, so we had to maintain them. There were the Maastrichtian church from the southern Pyrenees and this Miocene church from the Ebro Basin. And finally, what we observed that there were 2 formations that they fit very, very well with the main archaeological dispersion. One's the Oligocene church from the southern Pyrenees, and also the Miocene church from the northern Pyrenees. So we just, well, the differences between outcrop, we also observed that they were differences already concerning different outcrops from the same formation, just you can observe here. But then we did LAEC-PMS to try to solve these doubts, and there we quantified trace elements, and with the PCA with the 20 dose elements, what we observe that we observed that we had similar results as the ones obtained for the EDXRF. In fact, the formations that had been previously discarded were already again discarded, this Oligocene chert in blue and the Miocene chert from the north in green. And we also observed that some Oligocene formations, I showed you before that of one formation from the Oligocene, there are different outcrops, and with the EDXRF, we already have differences. So here with the PCA, we observed that two of these outcrops from the same formation could already be discarded. We observed for this chert that we were not quite sure. We are not quite sure again because they fit with the main archaeological dispersion, so we have to maintain them. And the chert that they fit very well, they again fit. So that's good. But then to try to solve these doubts with the Maastrichtian and the Miocene chert, we put here 3M, some specific trace elements, arsenic, uranium, and tungsten. And what we observe is that these Miocene charts and these Maastrichtian charts are far away from the main archaeological dispersion. And however, the Oligocene charts from the southern Pyrenees, mostly the Castelló de Farfanya outcrop, and also the Miocene charts, both of the study outcrops, fit very well with the archaeological dispersion. So we conclude that the lacustrine charts from Montlleó are coming from these both formations, one located in the northern Pyrenees and the other one located in the southern Pyrenees. First, I told you that we had two main archaeological levels, or two different archaeological levels at the site. So we could imagine that maybe people from the Lower Magdalenian went to one outcrop and people from the Badegoulian, Solutian Badegoulian, went to the other one. Well, in fact, we have put some of the samples in this graph, but we observed that it is not sure. So it appeared that people from the Lower Magdalenian exploited both formations, and this ancient occupation also frequented both outcrops. So just to conclude, what we have observed with this study that comprises several scales of analysis, the macroscopic, the petrographic, and also the geochemical, including geochemical methods, is that, in fact, the natural corridor of the Segre Tet River, which is just here, the river Segre, and then crossing by here the Tet River, it was regularly used after the Late Glacial Maximum, because for the main type of chert that appears in the site, they are using chert that coming from almost 100 kilometers to the northeast, and almost one, I think a bit more, 100 and a half kilometers to the southwest. We have also known by the exploitation of the local rocks that that demonstrate that people that occupied Montlleó, they had a good knowledge of the Cerdanya Valley because they used the available rocks to map there. But the presence of this church has allowed us to know that people that settled Montlleó, they frequented a large territory that comprises both Pyrenean slopes, as we have constated for types 1 and also for type 3. And type 4 here at the south. And in fact, the presence of long-distance charts, I didn't say, but for these three types that I said, there are scarce pieces. In fact, two of them we do not know the origin, not yet, but for the other one, it seems that they are charts coming from Chalos. We have only three pieces, but this, and if we add the presence of some Atlantic shells that had also been found at Montlleó, that could be the evidence of the existence of exchanges between groups, or at least what we know now is that the Pyrenees for these people took part of their territory, and that there were not barriers at the Late Glacial Maximum because they crossed maybe by here, but they could cross with other passes, and the Pyrenees were part of the human territory. And that's all. Thank you.